This constitutional matter that has been filed by the Prisons Officers Association in the immediate aftermath of the killing of one of their number once again. What is your position on that, and the feeling? And as the head, Seren Richard, said, you're redoubling the efforts, zero multiplied by two is still zero. Your perspective?
I don't want to engage Mr. Richards. He has his interest in looking out for his colleagues and his representative, but I don't want to engage him in the way he engages me. But I will simply say to you that if any citizen or anybody feel that their rights are abridged or infringed and they want to argue in the court, that is their right to do. And in fact, it probably would lead to some evolution of the law, because it's a novel argument which is being put to the court. I myself was surprised when I heard the details of the response of the state to some of the complaints. Because you see, we may be unaware of these things, and maybe the lawsuit has brought us the knowledge that we should have. So I don't have a problem with it.
And in the context of, for example, we're talking some of these issues, Prime Minister, they sound, you know, pretty lawyery and let's go in courts and so, but you talk about human beings in the same way that someone in some public service office have a file on a desk and they have no intention of signing it when all they need to do is sign it so the family could go ahead with the development of their home or whatever it is. Do you appreciate that in the case of prisons officers, in the case of pensioners, in the case of citizens waiting on proper service from government or government agencies, that you're dealing with human beings, with real
human beings?
Of
course, I appreciate that. And that is why we keep striving to have accountability so that these problems do not become chronic in the system. The whole question of accountability, if someone is held accountable, and I don't mean dollars and cents accountable. A file on a desk not being attended to, I'm sure that person reports to somebody else. And that somebody else has a responsibility to ensure that a file can't stay on a desk for God knows how long. I was surprised when that lawsuit you just mentioned came up. And I don't know if it's true, but I heard it on the radio being said as part of the complaint that there were murder situations where there was no file available. And I said, what? A murder being investigated, and in a question under the Freedom of Information Act, we're being told that a file doesn't exist on this matter. That was news to me. And of course, if that situation exists, then it should concern all of us in this country.